In this video, we're going to be showing you how to paint the blood-encrusted armour of the Iron Horde. Though this is aimed at replicating the armour of that particular Khorne tribe, you can use it for any other blood-encrusted armour. Now, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used lead belcher, which is perfect for all the colours we're going to be applying. Now, we're going to start by using Norn oil. We're going to shade this all over the model. Then after that, we're just going to do it on the trim as a second coat. So first of all, we'll be using a medium shade brush for this. I'm just going to dunk it into the pot. Get a little bit more than that. Now, I don't want to overload the brush too much, so I'm just going to soak some of that up like so, and then we're ready to start applying it all over. There we are with that all over shade now dry. All we're going to do now is do a second coat just on the trim of the armour. I just want to use a smaller brush for this, so I've got a medium layer brush. There we are with the shade now dry. We're going to move on to the next step, which is to apply some blood. Now for this, we'll be using blood for the blood god. Now I'm going to thin it down slightly with a little bit of water, and I'm also going to be using a small layer brush. So what I'm going to do is just get a little dollop onto my palette like so, a little touch of water, just so it's a bit more runny. I'll add a little bit more than that. There we are, that's better. So it's nice and runny now. Get a nice point to the brush like so, and then we're ready to start applying some of that into the cracks of the armor. So first of all, what I'm going to do is just run that around the cracks like there. Now don't worry if you splodge too much, because we can always add a bit of silver later anyway. But one of the top tips when doing this, if you do get a little splodge, just wipe it with your finger and it will just remain in those cracks ever so slightly. So the other thing we're going to do now is we're going to start applying it all over the helmet as well. So it gives it a really nice kind of contrast to the actual armor. So all over the helmet, and also just about halfway up his gauntlets as well, because he's obviously punched someone to death. Just keep doing that until his fists, all the armour's coated in those recesses, and his helmet's done. There we are, with all that blood and gore now applied to the armour. We're going to move on to the next step, which is start highlighting and layering the armour up. So first of all, we're actually going to highlight the armour first with a dry brush, then we're going to layer the flat panels just using Stormhost Silver. So first of all, let's start with that dry brush. I'm going to use a small dry brush here. I'm just going to get a little bit just on my brush like so. Then all I'm going to do is just keep rubbing that off like so until there's just trace elements left on the bristles. I'm happy with that, so I'll just give it a little rub there one more time. And all we're going to do is just start moving that actually across the armour. So I'm just going to gently start rubbing it back and forth. Don't want too much pressure on it. You're almost like tickling the armour, if you like. That'll start picking out those edge highlights and the rivets on the actual armour panels and the trim as well. With the edges of the armour now picked out with a dry brush, we're going to start layering the panels. Now again, we're using Stormhost Silver for this. I'm just going to start applying that neatly over those armour panels. Now you want to still leave some of the blood in the cracks. If you do find you actually accidentally go over some of that, then just reapply some blood after. Just take your time and just neatly fill in those panels. There we are with those armour panels now layered up. We're going to move on to the next step, which is to add some hard coat. Now, what this is effectively going to do is make the armour a little bit more shiny. Not something you normally expect or associate with Khorne warriors, but it gives it a very demonic and sinister look. So all I'm going to do is apply a little bit using a small layer brush, just to the palette like so. And all I'm going to do is then start applying that to those silver panels. Again, don't matter if you get into those recesses, because it doesn't matter, because it's shiny and the blood in there is shiny anyway. That is fine. So just do that on all those armour panels you've just picked out. And there we are with the hard coat now dry. Our Iron Horde armour is done. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy experimenting your own blood-encrusted armour, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.